The bumper maize harvest by Ugandan farmers this year has turned into a nightmare for many farmers. Reports from across the country show that farmers have been forced to sell their maize for as low as 200 shillings a kilogram. This could turn out to be a cyclic problem since farmers may be discouraged to plant maize next season, thus leading to a food shortage in the near future.
We have in Uganda what we call post-harvest loss. So our poor farmers lose a lot of product either on the way to market or unable to get it to market in time, and that's why prices drop. So I think, and this is something we've always said, is we need to sit down with all the key stakeholders and we look at end to end where are the challenges for the farmers and we deal them, and storage is one of them.
But financial institutions say that there is a solution that can shield farmers from these losses due to low maize prices. They can take loans using their produce as collateral and can engage in poultry farming to yield eggs, which remain on high demand in the region, or even dairy farming or adding value to their maize through other means.
We take the collateral of the product, whether it's maize, coffee, and we lend to the customer based on that collateral. And then as they release and sell that maize or the coffee or whatever, then they pay us back. So it's a nice mechanism to finance agriculture without requiring hard assets.
Meanwhile, Stanbic Bank released its half-year performance results, which indicate that credit uptake has improved, implying that businesses are gaining confidence in the economy. The bank has reported a profit after tax of 96 billion shillings, and since January, the bank has given out 263 billion in loans. This report was filed by Emmanuel Rubega for Urban Television.